The holidays are a time to be kind to one another, to show each other generosity, even if we get nothing in return. That's why I think this season's mascot should be the vampire bat. You heard me. Hey, festive friends, Julian here for DNews. Bats get a bad rep for pretty much no reason. Some of them eat fruit, a lot of them eat insects, but three species out of 1,300 suck blood and suddenly they're always associated with Count Dracula forever. It's just three. Three species! Ha 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 ha! So, I'm here today to try and convince you that bats should be a symbol of the holiday season. And because I like making my life difficult, I'm going to nominate the vampire bat. First off, I'm going to temper the freaky factor of vampire bats by saying that them sucking blood isn't even that bad. Okay, it's still pretty freaky, but hear me out. First off, they don't drink enough blood to harm their, let's call them blood donors, usually cows and horses, and almost never humans. Almost. They land on the ground near them, gallop over in a not at all horrifying way, and bite with their little sharp teeth. Incidentally, the common vampire bat is the only species of bat in the world that can run. Then they just kick back and lap up blood with their tongues for the next half hour. The blood doesn't clot because the bat's saliva has an anticoagulant called desmodiplase, also called Draculin. Seriously. And yeah, the bites may get infected, but come on, it's not like vampire bats know about antiseptics. Cut them a little slack. All right, I'm not doing a great job of defending the bat's honor, but consider this. Vampire bats are actually really generous to each other. You see, if a vampire bat goes 2 days without feeding, it'll starve. They're just tiny little mammals, after all. They need to be able to fly, so they can't have any fat stores weighing them down. And if you would just spare a little blood, they'd be fine. But no, you had to be selfish and need all your blood. And female vampire bats are better people than you. If a friend is going hungry, the bat will vomit blood into its mouth. Isn't that sweet? It's an example of a you scratch my upside down back, I scratch yours philosophy, or reciprocal altruism, and was first reported by University of Maryland biologist Gerald Wilkinson in 1984. Female bats actually keep track of who has helped them out in the past, and when they're asked to donate food to their friends, they'll do it without any fuss. If they're also on an empty stomach that night, they'll make up for it later by being extra giving. And if they've damaged a relationship in the past with selfishness, they'll work to repair it. Vampire bats embody the spirit of the holidays. They're giving, they're warm to each other, in a literal sense, when they huddle together in groups. And bats love dark places and are known to get into chimneys that aren't sealed up. So, with a little nudging of the mythology, vampire bats can be a holiday symbol from Halloween through Christmas. You wouldn't even have to put cookies out in the fireplace, the bats could just snack on you. And they usually number about 100, but can have groups as big as 1,000. So, imagine 1,000 tiny flying Santas coming down your chimney Christmas morning and sucking your blood. All right, I'm gonna come clean. I know this wasn't a very convincing argument to make vampire bats the embodiment of the season, but my Halloween decorations are still up, and at this point, I'm just too embarrassed to take them down, so just, you know, go with it, please, for me. If I've freaked you out about bats a little bit, let me make it up to you. Check out this video on how lunamaws make bats look like chumps. The problem for flying bugs is those flapping wings bounce back a lot of sound in a distinct way. They're like a ringing dinner bell for the bat. Now, some insects can pick up the ultrasound and stop flapping when they're in danger, but bats have responded by going quiet after they spot the bugs and are homing in. Okay, so who's on board with the vampire bat holiday train? Anyone? Do you have any better idea for a holiday symbol? Let us know in the comments, subscribe for more, and I'll see you next time on DNews.